Here we have an HDR, humanitarian daily ration, menu number one. It's a food gift from the people of the United States of America. That is one fine gesture, and Donald Trump could do quite well if he chose to use words like this instead. But this isn't about, well, of course it is about politics, but there's a humanitarian side to this as well, and this is usually airdropped on areas that have suffered from some sort of natural disaster like floods, earthquake, or famine areas. They're usually designed to be friendly to all religions, and whether you eat meat or you don't eat meat, if it's prepared according to your religious rituals and traditions, it's supposed to be friendly to everyone. It shows you what you do, you eat it. Written in three languages, French, Spanish and English. Chances are the people it's dropped on will not even be able to read or write their own language, but they can see by the picture what it's supposed to be for, and they will have been told that they will be helped by people with round eyes. They're called Americans. They're good people. So let's open this one up, which I've been waiting to do for a while now, and see what it contains. I want to keep the packaging for display, so I'll try not to destroy it too much. I can seal this up again. So there we have vegetables and barley stew. Lentil stew. I actually like the sound of both of those. They're in retort pouches. The picture shows you quite simply what you do. You just tear it open. They were packed in 2013, so they would last for many, many years. I got this from the guy in Rapid City, I think that was in Montana, but from what I remember, one of my old girlfriends lived for quite some time in Montana, and she said it was a hot, desolate wilderness populated by cowpokes. Whatever that means, but it sounded like my kind of place. But the temperatures, these are supposed to be stored in temperatures no higher than 25 Celsius. Possibly that part of Montana does get very hot. The barley stew also feels very nice. The packet's not bloated or anything. Strawberry jam feels a little bit rubberized. But maybe not. The sachet's a little bit puffed up, but not hard, so it's probably not fermented and turned to alcohol too badly. Peanut butter. That feels okay. The pouch isn't bloated at all or gassed up. Vegetable crackers. There's some kind of freeze-dried unfrosted toaster pastry. Brown sugar. I can't even begin to guess what that is, but I'll find out. Shortbread cookie, yeah, that's what it actually feels like in there. This isn't all squashed flat, which I'm very happy about, considering the journey it's been on just to get to me alone. You know, it went from Rapid City to Chicago Airport, and then to I don't know, it took about 3 days to get from Rapid City to Chicago, and then as soon as by UPS, great company, as soon as it got to the United Kingdom, it passed through customs at the airport pretty quickly, and then Royal Mail got hold of it and it sat with them for 2 weeks. This is a fig bar. I'm looking forward to this. Well, actually, I'm looking forward to all of this. So, first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to heat up the lentils and see what that's like. That smells really quite nice. Oh, there's just so much stuff in there. There's bits of garlic, onion, potato. It tastes, you know, kind of sweet. It looks great. So let's get that on there. Now, these can be eaten cold, but I don't think they would be so pleasant if they were cold. That's assuming that the people that this dropped on have some way of making fire. Now, in the little accessory pack, you don't actually get any beverage at all. Not even water purification tablets, which you would normally expect to find. But you do get a little wet wipe, a napkin, a tissue, a nice amount of sugar, and chili pepper flakes, salt, pepper. Generic MRE American type spoon. And a book of matches. It's a shame they could have gone the extra mile and put a tea bag in there, but maybe the people would find sort of Western tea quite disgusting compared to the brews that they drink themselves. But the smells coming from that are really, really nice. I'll keep this little accessory pack. I'll seal that up again. I'll keep that with the collection. Let's see how this is doing. That smells really, really, really okay. There's nothing wrong with that at all. I could have broken my hex tablet in two and saved it for the other pouch. Oh, that smells beautiful. Well, let's give that another bit of heat. While we explore the fig bar. Oh, well, it suffered a little bit in transit. But not too badly. It's got a nice flavour. It's just nice actually. It's a familiar taste of the preservative, the name of which escapes me. It's got the word phosphate in it. Yeah, that really is nice. It's actually got 210 calories in it, which not overly high. but very satisfying. It makes you feel good. The taste is really, really nice. It's really okay. Nothing wrong with that whatsoever. Well, this is heated through really nicely. Oh, it's just, the colour is so deep and so rich. Actually, it smells great, but flavour, tastes a bit like something I've made from scratch, but put too much of something in it. Yeah, maybe too much stock cube or something. It's not overly salty, it tastes quite dark. If I'd put like a bouillon cube in it, too much of a bouillon cube. But the flavour is, see, it's growing on me. Now, although it's suitable for vegetarians and people with certain religious beliefs, I wouldn't really know it. It just tastes like a normal sort of thing that I would knock up if that's all there was left in the cupboard. A pack of bouillon cubes, some salt, some pepper, some rice, and some whatever these beans are, adduki beans maybe. Oh, and lentils, obviously. Yeah. I would eat this and then wish that I had some money to go out and buy some proper food. But as far as surviving and keeping you alive, this will do it. There is a slight bitter aftertaste. Yeah. Which is a preservative. But you know, these things do have an incredibly long shelf life. You know, they're supposed to last 4 years, 3 to 4 years on the shelf. But you know, they can last for over a decade. And I've eaten food that old that I found in my nan's cupboard when I visited. You know, it's been there for so long and she's sure it's fine. Cooked it up, and it's only when I've read the packet after I've eaten it that I realised how old it was. But I wouldn't waste this. I would be very thankful to the people of America. Yeah. Nothing wrong with that. Yeah, nothing wrong with that. It would keep you alive. Maybe it could be spiced up a bit with pepper and the chili flakes. Okay. Yeah. I'm not going to waste the last of my hexane fuel block, so I've opened this one up. Got a kind of a funny looking glaze on it, but that's probably just fat. So I'll simmer that on what's left of this while I try some of the biscuits and the crackers. Oh, and absolutely finish this fig roll off. That's really nice. That's better than the little fig Newtons you buy. Yeah, I like the kind of pastry is soft ice, like a cookie kind of pastry. Very nice. Toasted pastry brown, might give that one a miss. Let's try a shortbread cookie. Oh, yeah, they look great. But so do the Russian survival blocks. Let's see what it bites like. Okay, yeah. Oh, sweet enough, not over sweet, but there's a cherry and an almond flavour to that, and maybe coconut, might be imagining the coconut, but definitely cherry, almond. So it's very not buttery, fatty, it's probably palm oil. I like that. Each one is 140 calories. But 60 of those calories come from fat. But it's going to keep you alive. It's not health food. It's not soul food. It's to keep you going. And that'll do it. Now this one, all the ingredients are all from Sopaco. So I guess that's where the whole ration is prepared, or all of the components are prepared. Now this is the toaster pastry. I don't even know if it's cooked. Ah, it's like a Pop-Tart. Apple, ginger. Don't have to put it in a toaster at all. It's nice eating like this. Pastry is pretty flat, heavy and flavourless. But the apple's nice. Maybe a little bit of cinnamon with it. Yeah, a bit of cinnamon and ginger. Yeah, it's making me feel pretty thirsty though. I mean, it's got to be nice. I'm shoving it down so quickly. Yeah, it's great. I didn't think it would be a fruit one. I didn't read the instructions properly, but I'm sure it didn't say fruit. It just said toaster pastry. So that's yeah, I like it. Well, let's try some of the preserve and the peanut butter on the crackers. Did want to save the crackers to see what they would be like with some of the barley stew. I did notice that it's packed for Sopaco, from Mullins, South Carolina. Now I've noticed South Carolina on other MRE components I've got as well. Yeah, these have got a kind of cheesy flavour to them, without having much flavour at all. So let's squeeze some of the peanut butter into one. There's no point in me trying to save this because I like it too much. I will just eat the whole lot. It's a smooth peanut butter. Let's see that. Again, it doesn't seem to have gone off or changed its composition at all. Yeah, that's really okay. Temperature's in double figures today. I think it's about 10 Celsius. So it flows quite well. Yeah, pretty boring. but it's got all the components you need to keep you alive. Got the calories, fats, the proteins, it's all there. It's so badly crinkled and faded or printed badly, I can't really see what the calories are. But it doesn't taste like poison, and that's always a bonus when you eat anything that's past its best expiry date. Okay, the jam's got a nice colour to it. It's not jet black. Yeah, that's okay. Yeah, that's great. It really is great. I don't want to eat all of this cracker. I was expecting this to be more like a rice cake from the texture through the vacuum pack. No, that's nice. Very nice. Well, what's it like on the fig? It might actually spoil the flavour of the fig roll. No. Yeah, the strawberry's not oversweet. It's not overly strawberry flavoured. It's okay, there's nothing wrong with it. Doesn't really go with the cookies either. It doesn't complement the flavour at all. Okay. So maybe that was a mistake. It was okay. Fig roll was really nice. Cookies are okay. Better without the jam. So let's try the vegetables in barley stew. Tastes like well, I've caught the pan a bit there at the bottom, that doesn't matter. I've got a way of getting those clean. Which is strange, I put it next to the sink and the next morning everything's all clean and on the other side of the sink. It's just amazing. Everyone should get one. Well, that looks nice. It's got no smell to it whatsoever. That's because it's wafting away from me. Yeah. It's kind of like a mush. You can taste the individual bits of flavour. You can taste the individual bits of potato, the individual bits of carrot. That's the potato, I'm guessing, but it's just... Well, maybe it has got some sort of substance left to it. But the whole thing is just tied together with this kind of gelatinous gloop that will keep you alive. And... Okay. tasted lots better. Lots better. But for a vegetarian dish, it's not a bad one, I suppose. Try a little scoop. See if it goes like on the cracker. No, that doesn't do anything for it really. So out of the two entrees, I say the lentil was much nicer. Even with the chili flakes in this and salt and pepper, it still wouldn't have much. I don't know. It's got a bit of flavour, but it's the texture. It's like a paste. And even the bits of barley have turned to paste now. I don't know if that's just the way the meal was processed before it was packaged, or if that's what's happened to it over time through bad storage. Nothing else seems to have deteriorated. But like all these things, as I start getting into them, I start thinking, it's nicer than anything I could make up myself. And if it's a choice between dying before rescue comes and surviving, then this is going to help you to survive. And this has come from the kindness of the American taxpayers' hearts. And most definitely will score political points as well. But as rations go, it's definitely not my favourite. I wouldn't buy one to keep for emergencies. I might buy another one and not open it for the collection. But then I might still be tempted to open it. But that's what you can get for your 2013 HDR menu number one. A food gift from the people of the United States of America.